We sit here today with only 4 months left in the current fiscal year. We are looking at a structural deficit. Whether or not both sides agree on the number, there's still a structural deficit. Pennsylvania's credit ratings have been downgraded. For my constituents here, I'm in Harrisburg with budget hearings. They ask if I'm coming home with a budget, and I explain to them this is for 16-17, and they want to know how are you working on a new budget without resolving the last one. It's almost embarrassing. It makes us as legislators on both sides of the aisle look ineffective. It makes us look uncompromising. It makes us look uncaring. Yet in December, we had a bipartisan agreed-upon budget because we can compromise and we can make concessions. Yet here we sit today with 4 months left in the current fiscal year. The window is closing quickly. Constituents remain at risk. Students are at risk. Human services are at risk. The governor outlined a revenue package similar to the plan in December. Sometimes people in this building forget that the revenue department needs to implement any tax changes that the General Assembly makes. It's not as easy as pushing a button. The money isn't going to appear overnight in a magic hat. Had we passed the budget in June or even December, the governor wouldn't need to propose retroactive effective dates. Secretary, when do we need to pass a budget by in order to meet those revenue estimates as they are based on presumed effective dates?
Yeah, I think you make a very good point, Representative, that with every passing day of delay, the cost gets steeper. You know, the proposed budget, as has already been talked about, would have made the proposed PIT increase retroactive to the beginning of the fiscal year. As we move deeper into the fiscal year, the opportunity to do that begins to lessen or goes away altogether. Sales tax changes, many of the provisions can only be made or have some lead time before they can be put into place, so that with every passing day, you know, to generate the recurring revenue necessary to meet those obligations, it becomes more difficult, and we simply have to increase rates or add additional items to generate the same amount of revenue as proposed.
I think that may have answered my second question, because I wanted to know what would happen if we fail to take action by the timeline that you're assuming.
Yeah, normally, particularly for the PIT, normally you would make adjustments or changes to that rate on a quarter. So, you know, without a budget resolution, you know, by April 1st, for example, then that imperils our ability to make that change retroactive.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary.